Jesus Christ is in every book of the Bible. In Genesis, Jesus is the seed of the woman. In Exodus, he's the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, he's the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. In Numbers, he's the pillar of cloud by day and the pillar of fire by night.
While I was
in Deuteronomy, Jesus is the prophet like Moses.
That all things must be fulfilled which were written in the law of Moses.
In Joshua, Jesus is the captain of our salvation.
I am coming.
In Judges, he's our judge and lawgiver. In Ruth, he's our kinsman redeemer. In 1 and 2 Samuel, he's our trusted prophet. In Kings and Chronicles, he's our reigning king. In Ezra, he's the rebuilder of the broken down walls of human life. Come and kneel before him now. In Nehemiah, Jesus is our restorer. In Tobit, he's the messenger of new life. In Judith, his weakness turned into victory. In Esther, he's our advocate. In 1 and 2 Maccabees, he's the leader who dies for God's law. Come and kneel before him now. In Job, Jesus is our ever-living redeemer. In Psalms, he is our shepherd. In Proverbs, he is our wisdom. In Ecclesiastes, he is our hope of resurrection.
We'll never die.
In the Song of Songs, he is our loving bridegroom. In wisdom, the emanation of God's thought. In Ecclesiasticus, Jesus is our security. Come and kneel before him now. In Isaiah, Jesus is the suffering servant. In Jeremiah, he's the righteous branch. In Lamentations, he's our weeping prophet. In Baruch, he is the mercy from the eternal. In Ezekiel, he's the one with the right tool. In Daniel, Jesus is the fourth man in the fiery furnace. Come and kneel before him. In Hosea, Jesus is the faithful husband forever married to the sinner. In Joel, he's the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit and fire. In Amos, he's the restorer of justice. In Obadiah, he's mighty to save. In Jonah, he's our great politician. In Micah, Jesus is the feet of one who brings good news. Come and kneel before him now. In Nahum, Jesus is our stronghold in the day of trouble. In Habakkuk, he's God my Savior. In Zephaniah, he's the King of Israel. In Haggai, he's the cedar ring. In Zechariah, he's our humble king riding on a colt. In Malachi, Jesus is the Son of Righteousness. Come and kneel before him. In Matthew, Jesus is God with us. In Mark, he is the Son of God. In Luke, he is the Son of Mary, feeling what you feel. In John, he is the bread of life.
I am the bread of life.
Jesus is the Savior of the world. Come and kneel before him now. In Romans, Jesus is the righteousness of God. In 1 Corinthians, he's the resurrection. In 2 Corinthians, he's the God of all comfort. In Galatians, he's your liberty. He sets you free. In Ephesians, Jesus is the head of the church. Come and kneel before him now. In Philippians, Jesus is your joy. In Colossians, he's your completeness. In 1 and 2 Thessalonians, he's your hope. In 1 Timothy, he is your faith. In 2 Timothy, Jesus is your stability. Come and kneel before him now. In Titus, Jesus is truth. In Philemon, he is your benefactor. In Hebrews, he is your perfection. In James, he is the power behind your faith. In 1 Peter, he is your example. In 2 Peter, Jesus is your purity. Come and kneel before him now. In 1 John, Jesus is your life. In 2 John, he is your pattern. In 3 John, he is your motivation. In Jude, he is the foundation of your faith. In Revelation, Jesus is your coming King. He is the first and the last, the beginning and the end. He is the keeper of creation and the creator of all. He is the architect of the universe and the manager of all time. He always was, he always is, and he always will be, unmoved, unchanged, undefeated, and never undone. He was bruised and brought healing. He was pierced and eased pain. He was persecuted and brought freedom. He was dead and brought life. He is risen and brings power. He reigns and brings peace. The word of God. world can't understand him. Armies can't defeat him. Schools can't explain him, and the leaders can't ignore him. Herod could kill him. The Pharisees could confuse him. The people could hold him. Nero could crush him. Hitler could silence him. The New Age can't replace him. And Oprah can't scare him away. He is life, love, longevity, and laws. His goodness, kindness, gentleness, and charm. He is holy, righteous, mighty, powerful, pure. His ways are right, his work is holy.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord.
I am the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall never hunger, and he that believeth on me shall never thirst. But I said unto you that ye also have seen me and believe not. All that the Father giveth me shall come to me. And him that cometh to me I will in no wise cast out.